Chief of the former head of the group of interlocutors in Jammu and Kashmir, Dilip Padgaonkar, advisor to the Chief Minister of Punjab, Mashijinder Singh Grewal, national spokesperson of the Congress Party and member of Parliament of the Rajya Sabha, Renuka Chaudhary. And my first question is to Ravi Shankar Prasad, deputy leader of the opposition in the Rajya Sabha and chief national spokesperson of the BJP. Ravi Shankar Prasad, your entire argument of a soft state that is soft on terror is blunted not once but twice. The government hangs Kasav and the government hangs Afzal Guru. The Congress seems to have been stumped by the decision this morning. The BJP appears to have been stumped by the decision this morning.
Arnav, I am very sorry to say that this rantings of yours is going since very morning, to which I take a highly, very strong offense, not only objection. It was a judicial process because of law, decision taken in August 2005, review rejected in January 2007, a delay of more than 8 years was there. But what we have said, a belated stand taken because the attack on Parliament was the attack on India. And we see it not as a political issue simply set up, one election or two election. We see it as a larger concern of securing the identity and integrity of India, of which the most visible symbol is the Parliament. Allow us to see like that. If the people wished, why you are asking me questions? The day Ajmal Kasab was hanged, you kept on ranting for the whole day, what about Afzal Guru? You have been equally concerned, Arnav Goswami, as every Indian must be concerned. And today is not the day of rejoicing. Today is not the day of scoring a political point. Today is the day to ensure that we rededicate ourselves to the resolve that of zero tolerance against terrorism. In that way, I see it.
Thank you very much for your keen observations and for your compliments right on top of the News Hour debate this evening. Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad, it is my bounden duty to remind you that the basis of what you describe as my rantings is the BJP's repeated instances on seven different occasions in May 2012 to have a white paper on why the government has become a soft state. And the argument of BJP leaders is that we have become a soft state because we have failed to hang Afzal Guru. This is the condition of our state. Afzal Guru was the cornerstone, the fulcrum, and the epicenter of not my rant, but your rant against the UPA for becoming a soft state.
Arnav Goswami, do we deny that the BJP has been very forthright in the fight against terror, and we shall continue to do so in support of security forces, in support of...
Yeah, they have taken your argument away.
Killed with impunity with... No, just a minute, let me complete now. We have heard you since morning. At least now hear us. The point I am trying to highlight is this. There will be occasions inside the Parliament and outside the Parliament to have a long debate on the issue of terrorism, as to where we went wrong, as to what more steps are required to be taken so that India remains secure and free. But today, when a decision has been taken, when capital punishment has been awarded, let us leave it at that, except to rededicate ourselves to the resolve of zero tolerance against terrorism.
I'm afraid my rant will continue for a little while longer, but I'd like to go to Renuka Chaudhary. Leave it at that, says Ravi Shankar Prasad. Your response?
Dawning of wisdom is what I'm saying. At last, they see that this is the way forward. Good. It's a good start for their new year.
Why is everyone saying this is political? The UPA took this decision because it's preparing for an election.
And this is
you want
ridiculous. I don't even want to dignify that by justifying. Who's speaking? Are you speaking or am I speaking?
No, I'm not neither speaking nor ranting. Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad says, do you want me to reply? But the question was to Renuka Chaudhary, and Mr. Prasad, I'll come to you the moment she finishes. Yes, please, Renuka Chaudhary.
there is nothing political about this at this moment. The timing is a natural conclusion of what was triggered long time ago. It just happens to come before Parliament. I mean, what does everyone expect us to do? Say that, no, we'll hang on to this till Parliament is over so that it doesn't implicate us? That's absurd. And it's cynical. It's a cynical way of looking at things. Today, an issue has been put to rest, and I think we should leave it at that. I don't even know why we are even discussing something like this on national TV. What is there to discuss on a man who attack this country?
Sir, because we need to.
And the governance has taken.
I'll tell you why we are discussing this, Renuka Chaudhary. I'll tell you why we are discussing this. We are discussing this because we want to be convinced that there is no politics behind these decisions. I mean, I can go on and on about how the Lahore bus trip was followed by Kargil, Kargil was followed by Agra, Agra was succeeded by the attack on Parliament was followed by Operation Parakram, Parakram ended without any outcome, and after that the government entered into a ceasefire agreement with Pakistan. But again, Ravi Shankar Prasad will say that I'm ranting. The fact of the matter is, Mr. Prasad, your argument is also rings a little hollow. Not only because of what the government has done, but because of your own track record, wouldn't you agree?
Arnab Goswami, I cannot question your right to reopen the wounds from 1947 itself. Why are you starting from Kargil? Go to 1965, go to 1962, go to 1948, go back further. But today is not the date for that. And I'm saying with all degree of certainty, I'm challenging you for a full-fledged debate on Kargil and Operation Parakram. I have been doing that with you in the past. I am willing to do that.
Thank you.
But I regret to say why you are reopening it today. Please don't do it. My reason is very simple. Today, a process, though delayed, has taken place. The idea of India, the security of India, the fight against terrorism, zero tolerance against terrorism is certainly important. I know I have a lot to say against Renuka Chaudhary and her party on the issue of terrorism, on a whole lot of things. But let us separate that debate for a different occasion. I wish to trust her that the decision is not election-oriented. And on behalf of the BJP, let me make it very clear to you, Arnab Goswami, we don't treat Afzal Guru issue as one election or two election. It is very important for India. That's how we see it. And I request for you to kindly see it that way.
Sir, all this while, Mr. Prasad, it was a political issue for you. Now that he has been executed, you are saying, I will not make it a political issue. For the last decade, I have heard nothing but politics over Afzal Guru.
And today you are saying that we will not make it a political issue.
Nevertheless, I
must clarify it here because you are accusing me. The BJP has been raising it not as a political issue, but an issue of security of India, an issue of integrity of India. And that's how we see it. And therefore, I gave the comment in morning, though belated, but the right decision taken. Not rejoicing, but the decision to really safeguard the security and integrity of India.
So when do you think Balwant Singh Rajwana should be executed? And don't you think that it is quite horrible that the state should become an advocate on behalf of a terrorist of the Babbar Khalsa who killed an ex-Punjab chief minister whose case is being openly advocated by your coalition partner? You say that the Congress should not do vote bank politics in the Afzal Guru case. I want you to call a spade in the case of your ally, the Shiromani Akali Dal, and not dodge my question by saying that the rule of law should take its own course.
I know this question was to come from you because this question you have been repeating this morning again. I'm sorry to say that. I hope for my program some different question would have been there, but since you have raised it, let me reply. The BJP stand, Arnab Goswami, is very clear and
categorical. It is the most relevant question.
On the issue of terrorism, all right, wait for my answer, please. On the issue of terrorism, there should be no discrimination. That stand we have taken very clearly, categorically, in Punjab and also the nation. But having said that, Arnav, it is very important that every accused has, or a person convicted has got the right to seek clemency. And if an application has been filed, we'll expect the government of India to immediately take...
He's not asking for clemency.
Disposal.
He did not ask for clemency.
He has not asked, but people on his behalf have approached. They have stated grounds. Take a decision on that.
Who are the people? It's the state. So please, sir, he did not ask. Your government asked.
Arnav Goswami, I wish to make it very clear to you. I understand that application has been moved by SGPC and not by the state of Punjab on a point of factual correction to you. But I'm only stating that let a decision be taken at the earliest, because the president will take a call upon the aid and advice of the government of India. I hope you are quite aware of the constitutional provision in that regard. But that right of consideration...
Well, I'm completely aware about this case. I know every detail. I'd like to go to Maheshinder Singh Grewal. I'm coming to you, Dilip Padgaonkar. On the 26th of March, Ravishankar Prasad, this is what the terrorist said. He said, I hear in newspapers that the Akali leadership, the Shiromani Akali Dal, BJP government are making efforts to get me mercy. Let me make it clear that I don't want or need mercy of the leaders of an Indian state that I do not believe in. This is what Rajwana said. Despite that, his mercy petition has been forwarded by the state government, something which has been criticized by the Supreme Court, which said that the Rajwana clemency plea was a drama enacted by the Punjab government, March 2012, sir. I am only pointing this out, not to score a brownie point, but to say, sir, you are on slippery ground. In the Punjab case, Maheshinder Singh Grewal, can you tell us why your chief minister wants to stop the execution? Mr. Grewal is also leaving the debate.